Hello and welcome to the episode 122 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. On our menu today, among other things, we have a couple of holiday breaks, several interviews, and a recording session. On the 2nd of May 1961, we have the usual residency concert at the Top 10 Club in Hamburg for the Beatles, with Pete Best on drums. Same lineup, same city 1 year later in 1962, with another performance at the Star Club in Hamburg, West Germany. In 1964, after completing the shooting of their first feature film, A Hard Day's Night, the Beatles departed with their partners for a well-deserved holiday. In the anthology book, Brian Epstein is quoted explaining the efforts to keep the holiday private. "We hired a company and told them we wanted a foolproof secret route plotting for four young men and three girlfriends and a wife. We wanted two destinations at which two sets of couples would link up. None of the arrangements were to be made by phone, and code names were created for the eight. Mr. McCartney was Mr. Manning, Mr. Starr was Mr. Stone, their companions were to be Miss Ashcroft and Miss Cookcroft. Mr. Lennon was Mr. Leslie and his wife, Mrs. Leslie. Mr. Harrison was Mr. Hargreaves, and his girlfriend became Miss Bond. Manning and Stone, Ashcroft and Cookcroft, were to holiday in the Virgin Islands. The Leslies, Hargreaves and Bond, would go to Tahiti." All of that was in vain. The Lennons, George Harrison and Patty Boyd, had to stop for 2 days in Honolulu, harassed by journalists. It went slightly better to Paul, Ringo and their girlfriends Jane Usher and Maureen Cox, who flew to Lisbon before leaving for the Virgin Islands. In the anthology book, Ringo remembers, "We'd been given John's and George's passports and they'd been given ours. It was still, oh, it's just one of them, give them any passports, they're all the same. Somehow we got to Lisbon and were checking into a hotel. Paul was wearing a disguise and the guy at reception said, 'Who's that?' Looking at the passport suspiciously, 'That's not you.'" Moving on to 1965, we find the Beatles travelling to the Antrobus Arms Hotel in Amesbury, where they arrived at 11:20 p.m. The hotel served as a base for the next 3 days, during which the Fabs would film the exterior military scenes for their help film in the surrounding area. Several items of clothing, cigarette butts and other souvenirs were stolen during the 3 days from the production limousine that was used to bring the band to the filming location. And we have a mix of work and fun on the 2nd of May 1966. The Beatles were involved with the taping of an interview for the 40th episode of BBC's Saturday Club at the Playhouse Theatre in London. Chatting with show compere Brian Matthew, they discussed the album they were recording, still without a title, and their upcoming North American tour, ignoring questions about their lower-than-usual public profile. The interview was aired on the 4th of June between 10 a.m. and 12 noon. Then, Paul McCartney and Ringo Starr remained to record individual interviews, again with Brian Matthew, to be broadcast in Pop Profile, a program produced by BBC for foreign broadcast. Ringo was interviewed between 5 and 5:30 p.m. and Paul between 5:30 and 6 p.m. The interviews were edited down to 8 minutes and sent around the world to selected radio stations. And after the work, Paul McCartney and Beatles assistant Neil Aspinall went out to Dolly's nightclub in London. The club was a usual meeting place for the Beatles and other VIPs in 1960s London. In the evening, they met Bob Dylan, Brian Jones and Keith Richards. And we'll close with 1969, with a day full of events. Let's start with the filming of an interview at the BBC's Lime Grove Studios, taking place between 12:30 and 1 p.m. The interview featured John Lennon and Yoko Ono talking with host Michael Whale about their film Rape, their second album Life with the Lions, the drug bust of October 1968, detailed in episode 291 of What a Fab Day, and Yoko Ono's subsequent miscarriage. It was broadcast in the evening, between 10:55 and 11:35 p.m., during the How Late It Is program. The day also saw the completion of the main filming for The Magic Christian, starring Ringo Starr. Since the schedule was respected and the production completed the work under budget, the executive producers gift Ringo, Peter Sellers, producer Danny O'Dell, and director Joe McGrath, plus the respective partners, with a trip to New York on the Queen Elizabeth II ship. Ringo himself was busy elsewhere, though, between 7 and 11 p.m., and then, later, between 1 and 3:40 a.m., he was with the rest of the Beatles at the EMI Studios, busy with a session produced by Chris Thomas. The session was focused on the remake of Something, with 36 takes of the rhythm track featuring George on guitar, Paul on bass, Ringo on drums, and then there's a disagreement between BeatlesBible.com and Beatles historian Mark Lewson regarding John Lennon. The website claims that John took part to the recording playing the piano, while Lewson's The Complete Beatles Recording Sessions has Billy Preston on piano and John Lennon on guitar. In particular, BeatlesBible.com claims that the extended ending of the song was in fact a jam led by John Lennon, based on a four-note figure later reworked into Remember for the Plastic Ono Band album in 1970. This long coda made the best take, number 36, 7 minutes and 48 seconds long. While it was erased in the final mix of the song, the coda was retained during the various sessions for the overdubs on the piece. Finally, Glyn Johns had another session at the Olympic Sound Studios today, toiling away on the 8-track tapes of the Get Back project. This concludes today's episode of this podcast. Tune in tomorrow for more stories about the four you love. Right now, you can visit www.simonmas.com/support to find out how you can make me feel your love. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.